Food processing facility sanitation is an integral part of good manufacturing practices. Effective sanitation aids in ensuring the wholesomeness, safety, and quality of shell eggs. The negative impacts on food safety and egg quality are a result of microbial growth. Research has shown that ineffective cleaning and sanitation practices or programs can lead to reduced quality duration or potential product contamination. Residual microorganisms can lead to egg spoilage or foodborne illness. Most of this training series will focus on the United States Department of Agriculture, Agricultural Marketing Service, pre-operational sanitation inspection expectations. However, remember that the Food and Drug Administration has oversight of consumer shell eggs in the United States, as stated in 21 CFR 117. Additionally, customers, accrediting organizations such as Safe Quality Food, British Retail Consortium, Global Standard, and others, as well as state and local regulatory agencies, may have additional facility sanitation expectations that can impact your facility. AMS sanitation requirements are meant to protect the integrity of the USDA grade mark by requiring additional sanitation expectations at facilities that utilize AMS voluntary grading services. To meet these goals, AMS inspectors will assess for voluntary grading program requirements during the pre-operational sanitation inspection and throughout processing operations by utilizing organoleptic inspection assessments. While AMS may review microbial test results as part of certain export programs, AMS does not conduct nor require swabbing or biological testing during routine sanitation assessments. So what is organoleptic inspection? Organoleptic inspection assessments include sight, smell, and touch. However, microbial growth will not always be seen, smelled, or felt. Critical areas are defined as equipment with potential surface contact with eggs or come in contact with wash water or air blown to dry the eggs. Non-critical areas are defined as areas that are not likely to imminently affect product quality. Non-critical does not mean it is not important. Non-critical unsatisfactory conditions should be addressed after the processing line has been started, unless unable to safely do so during processing. In this module, the critical and non-critical areas of the sanitation systems will be identified and discussed. Additionally, examples will be used to illustrate the unsatisfactory and satisfactory condition of various components associated with sanitation systems. Egg processing facilities shall be thoroughly cleaned at the end of each operating day. The term reasonably clean is applied during the egg processing shift to indicate that equipment and processing areas are maintained with minimum egg meat accumulation. More explanation of these terms is presented in the introduction module. All eggs processed under USDA Agricultural Marketing Service regulations must receive a sanitizer treatment before packaging. Sanitizer systems include liquid sanitizers or UV systems, which may be used exclusively or in tandem. Liquid sanitizers deliver liquid sanitizing compounds by sanitizer bars either within the washer immediately prior to the exit or self-contained sanitizer units immediately after the washer. All portions of sanitation systems must be available and accessible for assessment during pre-operational sanitation inspection. Sanitation systems must be clean each day prior to processing. Liquid sanitizer dispensing nozzles within the washer are considered critical. Nozzles must be clean and free of residue and debris. Liquid sanitizer dispensing nozzles within a separate sanitizer unit must also be clean and free of residue and debris. Nozzles, rollers, and areas above the rollers would be considered critical since moisture coming in contact with these surfaces could touch the eggs. UV sanitizing units should be thoroughly cleaned after each processing day. Care should be taken to ensure the sleeves over the lights are free of debris and clear. Excessive discoloration will impact the effectiveness of the UV sanitizing treatment. AMS will rely on confirmation of bulb changes at the manufacturer's recommended time intervals to verify sanitation effectiveness. Inspection of the UV sanitizing unit should occur only when the unit is turned off. The bulbs, rollers, and curtains, if present, are the only critical components of the UV sanitizing unit. As with all egg processing equipment, there is an expectation of thorough daily cleaning. During the processing day, egg meat located within or under UV sanitizing units can become denatured, making cleaning difficult. Care should be taken to ensure this is thoroughly cleaned. As mentioned before, exterior surfaces, legs, braces, feet, and conduit associated with sanitizing systems are considered non-critical, but are expected to be thoroughly cleaned each day. Sanitation assessment should always be conducted prior to the start of the processing line. In washing systems that were not manufactured with an internal sanitizing system, or that did not have enough room to add a separate sanitizing system, a small sanitizer compartment may have been added to the line. Such systems must be designed to ensure cleaning and sanitation assessment can be conducted. Access flaps, panels, or lids must be opened to assess cleanliness. Sanitizing systems are often segregated from washers by panels. When assessing the sanitizing system, make sure to look at the exterior plumbing and follow the plumbing into the interior components of the system. The exterior plumbing would be non-critical, while the interior nozzles and piping would be critical. This is a view of the interior spray nozzle bar of this system. Closer inspection reveals this to be a satisfactory, critical finding. Some sanitizing systems do not have a physical divider within the washer. AMS requires a separate sanitizing step after washing. Therefore, such nozzles dispensing the sanitizing rinse are located immediately after the brushes. The sanitizing component within a system can be located by following the plumbing from the sanitizing solution reservoir to the dispensing nozzles. In order to assess internal components of sanitizing systems, access panels should be lifted or removed. The buildup of residue on the internal surfaces of this sanitizing system is an unsatisfactory critical finding. The residue should be removed before processing begins. The nozzles in this view are clogged with buildup or other foreign material and are therefore unsatisfactory on a critical piece of equipment. They must be cleaned before processing can begin. UV bulbs can become soiled with egg meat. The example we see here is an unsatisfactory finding on a critical component. While UV bulb sleeves are a critical component, if residual material remains after corrective cleaning has been attempted and replacement bulbs are not immediately available, a time frame should be worked out with the USDA grader or grading supervisor to establish an appropriate time frame for correction. Here we see satisfactorily cleaned UV bulbs. The presence of occasionally small particles on the bulb sleeves would not be grounds for an unsatisfactory finding. Exterior panels and plumbing that service sanitizing systems are non-critical. The unit seen here has a hose which has become discolored. Discoloration alone would not be sufficient for an unsatisfactory finding, unless there was additional foreign matter on the hose surface. The hose clamp and other hardware mounting the plumbing should not be rusted, as seen here. The rusty hardware would be cause for an unsatisfactory, non-critical finding. The exterior panels of UV systems are non-critical areas. The surface rust and hard water staining on this unit would be an unsatisfactory finding on a non-critical area and should be corrected as soon as practical. UV units are equipped with curtains on the entrances and exits. These curtains come in contact with the eggs and are considered critical. If curtains degrade to the point that they are fragmenting and potentially causing pieces of curtain to fall on the egg, as seen in this shot, it would be a critical, unsatisfactory finding. If the curtains simply need cleaning, this should be taken care of before processing begins. If replacement is necessary, facility management should work with USDA AMS grading staff and supervision to come up with an appropriate timeline for correction. Sanitizing systems are a required component of producing USDA grade shielded eggs. Rollers, curtains, sanitizing nozzles, and UV bulbs are considered critical during pre-operational sanitation inspection. Non-critical components, including exterior panels, plumbing, braces, feet, and conduit, should still be cleaned each day.